I'm going to show you how to create always available on-demand connections to any cloud resource that will map those resources to your localhost address space so you can bookmark these in your favorite client applications to access your cloud. I'm going to show you how to do that at Google Cloud using Remote. The beauty of this is once you set this up once, you can bookmark this address and port and have an always available on-demand connection straight to your cloud database. And now you can use this database as if it were on your own local system. So let's take a look at how I set that up. What you'll need to do is launch an instance. Really any size will be fine. Let's call it instance one. Don't need to change any of this. Let's go into the networking section here. I'm going to use my own SSH key, which I'm allowed to do. You can have Google manage the keys for you if you like, but I like to use my own. And I'm just going to add one command to the startup script here. So we're going to go let that know that that's a command to execute. And then I'm going to go to the remote it application here, and I'm going to say add a device. This is a Linux instance. So I want to grab this code right here, this command, and then put that in the startup script for my instance. At that point, I'm ready to go. This is going to launch an instance and register it to my remote account with an SSH service active for me. So let's let it go ahead and do that. Now, as soon as that instance comes online, let's select it and look at the firewall rules. We haven't allowed any inbound traffic from the internet. The only traffic that's allowed to communicate with this instance has to originate from inside the private network in your Google VPC. So therefore, that instance is completely isolated from the public internet. There's no open port to protect with an IP whitelist, and so it's much easier and cleaner to manage from that standpoint. Now, before we leave the Google Cloud console, I want to show you that I also have a database in this VPC that I have launched previously. And that database has a private IP address that is only reachable or addressable from inside the private network in this Google VPC. So I'm going to copy that. We'll need that in a minute when we go back to remote it. Now there's just one more step here. I'm not going to walk through all the steps one by one, but we need to create a service account to allow us to connect to what's called the Google Cloud SQL proxy. So this documentation from Google will guide you how to create the service account and install the Google Cloud SQL proxy on that same instance where we installed Remote It. But once we do that, we're good to go. So with that, let's go back to our Remote It account where we will expect to see that instance auto-registered. Let me just turn off that search filter and we'll see. There it is right there, instance one. That's the name we gave it. And it registered in my account and has an SSH service available to me to connect with immediately. Now, the nice thing is I can now configure that instance to give me connections to any service, any resource in the same VPC at Google. Setting up access to any other resource in that VPC is easy. Let's just click in here. Remember, we have our database that we set up. I'm going to hit the plus, MySQL, which will auto-populate that port for me. And remember, we copied that local IP address inside the private network in our Google Cloud. So we'll just go ahead and save that off. And that will now register to my account and give me an on-demand, always available localhost IP and port to connect to that database and use that cloud database as if it were right here on my own machine. Switching back to MySQL Workbench, we now can bookmark that localhost and port and go ahead and start our connections, just like that database was local here. And what's nice is I don't have to switch between different VPNs. I can have open connections at multiple cloud environments at the same time, or on-prem, or really anywhere.